tonight.
Yes, yes.
To buy my pardon and empty grave.
Yes,
is that a proof?
All right.
My Savior lives.
Amen. You know what I'm saying? You preach it.
Yeah.
Amen. Amen. We're going to move on to our text on this morning. Giving honor to God, who is my Father, to His Son, who is my Savior.
Yeah.
To the Holy Spirit, who is my helper, my interpreter.
Yeah.
The Deacon Pierce, first Deaconess, Sister Pierce. To all of the deacons here at the Mount Olive Church family.
Yeah.
Mother Himpia.
Yeah.
Amen. God bless you, baby. Yeah. And most of all, each one of you, I do, my Father's children, I do greet you.
Amen.
In the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. It is because He lives.
Yes, yes.
I don't know about you, but it's I can face tomorrow.
Yes, thank you, Lord.
Because He lives. All of my fear is gone.
Right.
Amen.
Amen.
And it's because that I know Mother Jante, who holds my future.
Right.
Life is worth living.
Yes.
Just because I know Jerry, my Savior, my Savior, He lives.
Yes. Amen.
If you have your Bibles with you, your roadmap, a copy of God's Word, your GPS, whatever you call it. If you have that with you on this particular day, would you turn with me to a very probably unfamiliar passage in the Old Testament? Amen. That is the book of Samuel. That is 2 Samuel. There are two Samuels. 2 Samuel. Go with me to that ninth chapter. Amen. Ninth chapter of 2 Samuel. On this manner, Master, that we even know how. Come, O God, just to say thank you for your grace, your mercy.
Yes,
thank you for your love, and most of all, we thank you for your Son, Jesus.
Yes.
Who died, Lord God, that we might have a right to the tree of life. Now, Master, I ask, O God, that you would use me in your service. Lord God, draw me nearer every day. For Lord, I'm willing to run, Master. Not all of the way, O God, but I'm willing to run all of the way. But Master, if I happen to stumble, Lord, while I am trying, O God, don't be angry, Master, but just let me stand. For Lord, I'm willing to run all of the way. And I'll be very careful to give you all the praise, all the glory, and all of the honor. For it's in Jesus' name we pray and for His sake. Amen. And amen.
Amen.
Once again, it's my privilege and honor to greet you in the precious name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Thank God for each and every one of you. Remember what kindness was like. David might have remembered what mercy was like. David might have remembered what compassion was like.
Yes,
and then David remembered the pact, the covenant that he made with Saul's son, Jonathan, which was David's best friend. They made a covenant together. And they said that David, Jonathan knew that one day, that David would be the king. And he told David, whenever you become the king, David, I want you to promise me one thing, that you won't forget about my family. You all know when kings usually took over a domain, they usually killed everyone in the other family.
Right, right.
But Jonathan and David made that compact that David would remember the family of King Saul. And once David became the king, David remembered the covenant that he made. I mean, he wasn't at the king at the time that they made the covenant, but they knew that one day he would become the king. We have to realize some quote said that the only people you should try to get even with are the ones who helped you. I mean, sometimes people want to get even with someone else, but the people that you should get even with are the people that have helped you up the way.
Yeah.
Amen, somebody.
Amen.
One of the most difficult things to give away is kindness. Amen.
Amen.
It is usually this unreturned. Amen.
Yeah. Amen.
When you give it away. When I was young, I admired clever people, Deacon Pierce. But now, child making 3 zeros a year. No more $1.25 an hour, but I'm making $17 or $18 an hour. So I'm making more than that. You need to remember back where you came from.
Amen.
If someone helped you along the way, if someone was kind to you along the way, if someone showed you some mercy along the way, if someone showed you some compassion along the way, guess what? You need to reminisce like David.
Say that, Pastor.
I told that woman I was going to help her kids, but I can't afford it now. I don't know what they're coming to me for. Huh? Come on now. You made that promise to someone? Did you tell someone that? Huh? Since you're not here, baby, when I went to visit you at the hospital, the last conversation that we had was, baby, don't worry about your kids. Baby, don't worry. And whatever they need, I'm going to be there for them. Then some years passed on down the line. See, some years passed for David. He wasn't automatically the king right then. It took some time before he became king. Huh? But when he did get a good job, when he did get that 5-bedroom house with 3 or 4 baths in it. When he did get that vehicle that he wanted. He didn't forget about what brought him to where he was. He didn't forget about those that helped him along the way. That's one of the problems in our life today. Sometimes we need to reminisce and remember who helped us along the way.
Yeah.
Because as quiet as his camp, David said, and David said, is there yet any that is left of the house of Saul that I may show him kindness for Jonathan's sake? Find someone. Show them some mercy. There is mercy for a lame man. You got to remember and reminisce on where you come from. And David just didn't remember that David also had to react. He wasn't just a whole bunch of talk. David did what he said that he was going to do. He reacted. He went out of his way, Pastor. He went and summoned someone that was left of the household of Saul. Didn't know if anyone was left. All of them could have been dead, but David wasn't concerned about that. He summoned someone, sent out a search warrant, got a private investigator, go and find someone. When you find him, man, go and find someone. See if there's one live alive that's of the household of Saul. No, I don't want him to kill him. I want to find him so I can show him an act of kindness. I want to find him so I can show him some mercy. Because there is mercy. Well, amen. And I believe it was Ziba, the servant, that brought back the report. And said, and Ziba came back and said, there is one that's left of the household of Saul, but he's living in Makwar of Lodibo. And matter of fact, he's lame on both of his feet. You see, when his nurse heard the battle of Gilead, where Saul and Jonathan and Saul's sons was killed fighting the Philistines, she got so excited, she grabbed up Mephibosheth and she began to run with him. And while she was running, she fell. And when she fell, she messed up both the boy's feet.
That's the word.
And he was lame on both of his feet. So he was hiding out, Deacon Pearson, in Lodibo. Lonely Bow was like a place of refuge. Lonely Bow was a place like for people to kind of talk to, but they didn't talk about you in Lonely Bow. You kind of could blend in with the crowd. If you had been in jail, wouldn't nobody talk about you? If you were on drugs, wouldn't nobody talk about you? Lonely Bow was kind of like a place of refuge. How so sometimes when you was in Lonely Bow, you were kind of in shame and you were kind of in hiding. You didn't want anyone to see you in the condition that you were in. Help some child on drugs, someone help someone that's cast away. We have someone in Lonely Bow right now. They don't want to come around their parents. They don't want to come around their relatives. They don't want you to see, look at their face and see how much weight they lost. So they're shameful. They have that in Lonely Bow. And they are waiting, for Sarah to come to them, and invite them back home. They're waiting for someone to find them, show them some mercy, show them an act of kindness, show them some compassion. Sometimes I ask myself, compassion, where have you gone? Seem to be no compassion in the world today. Everyone wants justice. No one wants to show compassion. No one wants to show kindness. Compassion, where have you gone? You ask yourself that. Are you showing someone compassion? Are you showing someone kindness? Are you showing someone mercy? I mean, that's the question for every one of us from this lesson. There are lessons to be learned from the Old Testament. The Old Testament concealed is the New Testament revealed. There are lessons to be learned from the Old Testament.
Yes, yes.
God have always shown some kindness, haven't he?
Yes.
Israel was in Egypt. God heard their cry.